The impact of service to any organization can never be overemphasized. It is the oil that grinds, that makes the wheel function effectively. We've talked about the impact of customer service on our business as a whole, as it affects the brand. We have also talked about, gone deeper to understand what service delivery means. When we have failures, how do we intend to go about, because they are going to come, because there are challenges and the things that make service delivery become challenging, like technology, like skills mismatch, lack of fitness for role, and all of that. Now, because of that, we will move to the third module that talks about the basic skill sets of customers, service rep or relationship managers, and also how to develop these skill sets as we go ahead. So we'll move to the next module, which is module 3, that talks on the skill sets for improved service delivery and how to develop these skill sets so that we can improve our retention of our customer service, the retention of our customer's business. So the first thing I want to know is more like a self-awareness kind of assessment for yourself. The first thing you need to know about is how you operate as a person. In emotional intelligence, they call it self-awareness. You need to know the best time that you operate, how easy it is to operate with your customers, and who eventually are you. You also need to understand your business too. What are the dynamics of your business? How do your business operate, and what are the high points and low points of your businesses? You need to understand, obviously, the customer, because the customer is who you intend to serve. Having known yourself, having known your business, the next thing to understand is your customer, and likely understanding your environment where you operate. You not forget that we do not operate in vacuum or operate in isolation of our customer. We operate with our customers, which are internal customers as well as external customers. And as a customer service professional or a relationship manager, there are some particular traits that you must have that will aid you in offering effective and friendly customer service. The first thing is, just like I mentioned, friendliness. People that are friendly becomes people that have so many friends. They say if you want to be friendly, you have to position yourselves as a someone that is accommodating and that someone that will easily want to people. So one of the first thing a customer service champion or relationship manager, whatever way you want to call it, is being friendly. You also need to be empathetic. You must be able to learn how to put people, learn how to treat people as you would treat yourself. You need to know how to understand people and also sharing the pain points and put yourself in their shoes. And this takes a whole lot of proactivity. You might need further study on that, on how to improve your empathy skill and how to improve in how to put internalize customers' need more, so that you understand what they need and you'll be able to provide for them. And that's a whole lot of proactivity on your part. Effective service delivery champions or relationship managers are also knowledgeable people. They strive out to know more, to be more, and they're quite intelligent. So you need to be intelligent so that you able to anticipate customers' need. You can look at the trends and look at what has been going on in the market and provide the global practices and best practices of ideas, solutions, and problems, and products and services to provide for your customers. You must also manage your time perfectly well. When you understand the concept of time management, It gives you a sense of purpose and urgency to act, to always want to meet your customers' need and also want to improve on what the customer needs and what is important for the customers. Now, customers are everywhere, you know, but not everyone can be your customer. So in areas that you would eventually be exposed to, now you know that your customers are there seeking you, and we're asking us, how can we locate them? One of the ways you can locate them is through networking. Networking entails connecting people who share the same business goals and ideas, so that there could be a calibration and of business opportunities during that interaction processes. In this module, I will delve so much on networking, because networking gives that critical mass that we require in helping us become better as we serve our customers and all of that. Volunteering to the ways where you volunteer, when you volunteer sometimes and offer free services to customers and to a prospect, you can eventually convert them into becoming customers. And when you serve them very well, they could turn out and give you referrals. When you give them, and also they could aid by spreading your company, your product, your services through word of mouth advertising. Word of mouth advertising is the cheapest form of advertisement anyone can get, and any business should always ensure that their customer service team or relationship managers or the sales team ensure that they are performing so that they can get recommendation, which dovetails to word of mouth advertising. And of course, you do surveys, product test, product launch. These are areas whereby you can get customers and how to get them. So let's talk about networking per se. The picture to my on top of me is a picture of Jack Dorsey, the CEO of Twitter, and you could see that he has one of the largest large selfie. Look at this as a network. The number of people in that space would further promote that picture to us. So networking is the way in which businesses locate each other, by connecting with each other through a medium and a process and all of that. You can imagine when you were in the university, you would almost talk to yourself and talk to other people and introduce yourself to them as much as possible, so that people could know you and you could have friends with other people. So that's how networking works. It's more like a tree-like, web-like kind of interaction, whereby people come together and with that you share ideas, information, share contacts, and even share ideas and solutions together. There's so many events that you see around that could pass for networking events. You have networking events that come up, and you have online events that might eventually turn into networking sessions for you. Your ability to become a powerful networker is it's on you. You need to learn how to have the skills and the necessary competencies to network effectively, you know. And in the sales world, what you would need to know is that you would continually have to learn how to socialize and ask for referrals, and also learn how to create webs of friends that would support your success and help you grow. Businesses grow when we grow together, and when there is awareness, and that awareness comes from people that you know, as well as the channels which you have used to advertise your products, services, and offerings. See, one thing about networking is that it sustains and expands your reach and your outreach, and that is how businesses survive in today's market situation. Now, there are other places where you could get to network. There's so many of them. You could network at religious gatherings. You could network in your normal clubs and associations that you have meetings. You could network in seminars and conferences, like I mentioned earlier on. There's so many of those places you could network. The community development programs, when you relax at the bars, when you travel, and even now we have so many online chat groups and network groups that have course related ideas, and these are places whereby you can have a large number of people to talk to about your products, your services, and your solutions. For me, and what I will always want to say, the first thing that you need as a salesperson and customer service is your ability to smile. Your smile must be effortless. You must be able to smile at all time, and it must be genuine. People must see you that you're genuine at heart, and you're good to go with them. You're friendly, you're personable, and you have things that are important for you. In networking environments, make sure that your telephone number and your email addresses are handy, and they can be easily shared and stored. Of course, technology has also made this quite important and quite exciting, and makes everything work well. So the skill sets that we mentioned earlier on is that the skill sets of friendliness, of having genuine interest in people, becoming better and knowledgeable in your operations and all of that. You know that locating businesses in today's locating customers today in today's business take a lot of understanding, a lot of mastery, but most importantly, a lot of deliberateness. You must be intentional about what you want to achieve, and you go about achieving them. You recall earlier on that when I mentioned about networking is critical. It helps you build businesses, and it helps you sustain your business growth. So I want you to have this understanding that the ability to become effective and efficient in your processes would likely improve the opportunity of keeping your business going through by satisfying your customer effectively and efficiently. So that is it about learning how to manage your customer's experience and how to do the best and be the best that they can ever do and deal business with. It is important that you know that. So thank you once again. Now we've come to the end. I will give you some tips. The first thing is ensure that you smile always, be personable, make sure that you're able to get businesses done, and make sure that the easiest way to get your customers back to you and to keep coming to you is to provide excellent service. And one of the ways to providing excellent services is to understanding who your customers are and what they actually need and what is important for them. So I look forward to you joining me in other subsequent presentations on locating your customers and getting the best out from them. Thank you once again, and enjoy the rest of the day.